What's up, guys? Big Rob here with DIY Church Tech. Today, we're talking about Proclaim presentation software. We have been using Proclaim for about 90 days. I have gotten down and dirty with this setup. I've learned a lot on it. Kind of want to translate that and help you guys out. If you're watching this video, you're either looking for Proclaim as a possible presentation software, or you already use Proclaim, and maybe you're trying to figure out some different things you can do with it. In that case, this video is going to be good for both of those situations, but please be aware this is a very in-depth piece of software. This is not a video that I can make in 5-10 minutes. It's going to be probably a 30-minute long video at least. This is just going to touch the basics of Proclaim, the different areas of Proclaim, the different sections of the editing, how to set your projector system up, and going through the cloud and how to access the media through the cloud. So starting up here in the top right-hand corner, this is our cloud area. So this is your user you're logged in, any announcements or any notifications you might have from your other users or Faith Life, your message center between you and your other users, and then your sync notification. So if you click that right there, it will sync your machine with the Proclaim cloud so that your presentation has the most up-to-date media for that presentation and that your presentation is now saved to the cloud. Before we get into the nitty-gritty of designing a presentation, let's talk about setting up our system to work with Proclaim, or setting up Proclaim to work with our system. So the first thing here are your monitors, and you're going to see how many monitors you have on your system, is however many monitors are going to show up here in Faith Life. So if you have 5 monitors, like we do in our Sanctuary computer, we have 5 outputs on that computer, you'll see 5 different selections on that computer. So, and talking from the top is your application monitor. You're always gonna default the application monitor. The application monitor is always gonna default to your primary Mac monitor or primary Windows monitor. So you can't accidentally throw the control screen up on the projector. Whatever your primary monitor is, that is where your application is going to show. The next monitor here is number 2. We have set up here for our slides. If you had a 3rd monitor, you could set that 3rd monitor up for a confidence monitor. If you had a 4th monitor, which we do in our sanctuary, you could set that up for notes. Notes are going to be, if your pastor has certain notes for his sermon, the notes will show up on that monitor. So like we have a monitor on our stage that is in a stage monitor wedge box. Looks like a floor monitor from the audience side, and it has notes in it for the pastor or for the worship leader. So every slide element can have different notes attached to it. And then you can see down here, you have foreground only, background only. Foreground only is gonna be just the text, all right? So just your text is gonna be foreground only, or just the background is going to be background only. Let me see if I can give you guys an example of what those look like real quick. Let's go to Build My Life. Here, let's go settings. Let's go display, and we'll just use this one. So slides foreground only. And we'll say not used there. So we're on Build My Life, and let's just go live with that on air. So you can see here, it's a black background and it's just the text. So this is all that gets outputted on that one right there. There is a way that you can chroma key. So let's set that to the green. I'll show you that real quick. Life, go on air. So that's what gets outputted. We put a black bounding box around all of our lyrics on screen. That's why you're seeing that black box. So if you run a streaming software and you stream your service, you want your lyrics on the screen, you can set this color as your chroma color, and all you're going to get is the text on the screen. With warmth arms, you are peace, and your love won't let me go. You have spoken, and I know that it is. if you do a confidence monitor, let's do set up a note. Hey, don't sing this like poop. We go settings. Let's change my display for this one that's being recorded to the notes. So on the TV screen right now, you can't see it. It is showing the lyrics for Build My Life. But on the note section, as you guys see on my screen here, it says that note, hey, don't sing like poop. And then the confidence monitor. Confidence monitor. Right click. Air. So that's what the confidence monitor looks like. So your main text is what's up here. Your song is up in the top left hand corner. The time is in the bottom right hand corner. The song that you are singing, the current lyrics that are up now is in the middle of the screen here. And then what's coming up is in the bottom left hand corner of the screen there. So that's the way the confidence monitor looks for Proclaim. All right, let me go back here and uncluster this. What I've got done here. All right, slides. There we go. So, other settings here. Presentation. Now, you have the option of setting a 4:3 or a 16:9, and that is going to be for the entire presentation you're working on. The neat thing that Proclaim remembers is it remembers your aspect ratio not on what machine you're hooked up to, but on what presentation you're working on. So if I set a presentation to 4:3 and open it back up in another computer, it will pop up as 4:3, which is really nice if you're working on a presentation at home that's going to be on a projector at church that's in a 4:3 aspect ratio. You don't have to necessarily wait on or have to train your volunteers to re-aspect ratio, to change the aspect ratio of the presentation. It just remembers it. Now, if you do find a situation like we do is where we create media content for our main worship server, for our main worship center, and then that content gets shown on the fellowship hall screen, which is 16:9, or up in the youth room, which is 16:9, then you can very easily change that over to a 16:9. You see over here, it just changed it in the background there, and it will reformat everything it needs to reformat. It takes it a few minutes the first time you change it over, but it'll reformat everything to fit a 16:9 format. Quick screens. These are going to be screens, as I call them. So they're going to be on the F1, F2, F3, F4 keys, and you can hit one of those keys anywhere you are in the presentation as while you're on air, and that will show up. So that logo right there would show up if we hit the key corresponding to that logo. It's kind of a uh-oh, or if you just need to throw something up real quick. If the service gets off track of where you are, you may not have an element designed for it. If the service is, you know, flowing organically and you guys do a song that's not necessarily in the thing, you can put the logo up real quick while you fix that, and then you can show your content. Default confidence is how you change your confidence monitor. Default media is where you can set what your default text style and background style is for certain elements. So if you have a certain way, like our songs you saw there, is white text and black bounding box. That's my default media with this kind of wave background. So it's a very neutral looking slide so that if we have to throw something at the last second, it's already formatted for us and ready to go. Lighting and MIDI, that's something we can touch on later, but you can use this to trigger Ableton or have Ableton trigger this or have this trigger your lighting console for seeing changes as you change elements within Proclaim. Almost said Media Shout. So now that we know how the software sets up and we've got the software somewhat set up to our system, let's talk about actually navigating and driving the software. So there are two main modes to Proclaim. One is edit mode and one is preview mode. When you're in edit mode, you can change any of this here that you want to look at. And if you are on air, which means on air means you're up live on your screen, none of your edits will change until you go back into preview mode. So if you are working on, let's say the sermon slide is up for the pastor and you're on air for the pastor and you're working on his slide and you go edit and you need to change some lyrics on Build My Life, that's going to stay live on the screen. The pastor, that what's there is live, and you can always tell what's live on the screen by the red arrow. So the red triangle arrow tells you what's live on the screen. The yellow line and what's highlighted is what you're actually editing and looking at. So if we go to preview, you'll see we go back to what it was actually being shown on the main projector screen. Let's go off air here. So let's move from this presentation I got here, which is something I kind of tried to do for this video, and let's just open up one of my rundowns for a service here. So you've got four different sections on your rundown over here. So let's talk about the different areas of the software first. So on the left-hand corner, you have your rundown. In the center here, you have your content area where you edit the content that's on the screen. On the right-hand side here is the preview, the edited preview of what you're editing. So as you change something, welcome home, people, it's spelled wrong, but you get the point. As you edit, it changes there. You can add more text box if you want to and put another text box in there. There's actually already things done, so you can say, I want to put the Facebook information in. So there's my Facebook information. So everything's kind of already done for you. There's not a lot of, my website for the Facebook, for the church, you can put in there. Not my website, I mean the church's website. So everything's really kind of already done. Like, because you put this information in when you register for Proclaim, you put all this in, and it kind of just remembers it. So, like, the church address, I believe, maybe in here. Nope, but you can even do, like, the Wi-Fi network, the Wi-Fi password, if you want to have that information up on the screen. It's pretty neat what you can do with the software there. So that's the edit window, preview window. So your pre-service loop over here in our rundown is just what it says. It is a pre-service loop, and it is going to be all of the different announcements that you want to run pre-service. This is going to just loop over and over and over again. That's spelled wrong. Let's change that real quick. It's going to be all your different announcements you want to run before the service, and it just loops over and over again. And if you notice, these are all timed differently. So a slide that says, like, something simple, please silence your mobile devices, 7 seconds, versus something with a little more text and information on the screen, Proclaim automatically assigns to a little longer time to it. If you notice these blue speaker icons next to this means that there is background music playing on all of these, okay? And the way you do that is you can come here and you can add audio tracks. So we have loaded in a lot of different songs here, so you can select the music that you want to have play maybe for that Sunday morning. And then you say you can add those elements in there, and then you can see your playlist. You can click and drag this around. So if you want to have different music playing as you get closer to the service, maybe you start off kind of mellow and you hype up as you roll in there. You can set that as well. Or you can have it set to just shuffle like we do. You can say that I want you to play the playlist once, or I want you to, however you want to play. It's pretty good about that. The next section we're going to talk about is the warm-up section. And this is where we typically put our countdown to start the service, 3 minutes before service starts, and then our church welcome video plays, which is a welcome to our church video. And then we roll into the service elements there, right? You'll notice that there's a red icon here because I don't want any background music playing when we get to service. So I will go ahead and automatically click that there. Other thing you can do here with the audio is you can add certain songs. So like, for example, when I am timing tracks, I will put the track that we're going to be using on the actual slideshow, so I can go through and make sure the lyrics are in the right, the right order, and so on and so forth. So we go through here. You see the next cue we have is a start recording. So this is this machine at the church that we use has audio input from the console. So we record the pastor's sermon, and then we stop recording the pastor's sermon, and it automatically uploads it to our Faith Life account. And from there, I can populate to YouTube and so on and so forth that I want to do. And then at the end here, as we're done, you can see music starts again. And then we have our post-service loop, which is just another announcement loop that runs at the end of service. So what I want to do real quick here is I want to give you guys an idea of what it looks like for the software to auto-run itself in the at the beginning of a service. So meaning that let's run the pre-service loop, let it run to the warm-up, and let it run into the beginning of the service. So this is what we do on Sunday mornings is about 10 o'clock when we're done with rehearsal, we will put the computer into on-air mode. What that's going to do is going to start running the pre-service loop. Now, we start our service at 10:50, but the time is not 10:50. So let's set this. We got 4:12, 1:43. It's about 6 minutes. So 6 minutes from now would be 12:29. PM, and then let's go on air. And you'll hear that our pre-service music is going to start, and this music is going to play behind in the background on our sound system we have in the sanctuary. And we have a playlist that we actually have loaded to Proclaim that has all the different songs in it that we usually run on a Sunday morning for our pre-service loop. And it'll just play those songs, and it'll play this music, and it'll loop through the announcements till it gets time for it to run the warm-up. I'm not touching anything right now. It does all this by itself. It's pretty cool. Here in a second, it's going to move from the announcement pre-service loop into our warm-up. So here's our warm-up, pre-service warm-up, which is the countdown, and then the welcome to service intro video. So about right now in the video, the band should be up on stage already because the welcome video is after this. It's about a minute long. Band's getting ready to start the worship set because as soon as warm-up is done, the first song triggers and the band starts. What I have really like about this is it keeps you on time. We used to have a really bad track record of not starting on time. We used to start it like, 10 after, and it was really bad. So I like the fact that the software, you know that it's running, and you know that at 10:50 or whatever time you tell it to start, it will start running the service. And if you're not in place, you're gonna look stupid. So it really helps keep us accountable for starting on time for our service. And as this video ends, it should fade into the next element, which is the welcome to church video, which should be starting right about now. And so now the next song will run, which is Glory to Glory, the first song in our. And so on and so forth. So you'll notice that I had the start time at 12:29, and it's 12:29. And that's how the beginning of the service typically countdown runs for that. Service together, right? So this is a good time to talk about how to import songs. So you're gonna go add item song, and it's gonna add a new song into your presentation there. So let's just do one that I know is already formatted correctly, Build My Life. So this is Build My Life. We added a new song, so you can see we have a default background and the default way that our text is set up, right? So the way that Faith Life works with your lyrics and editing any content is you edit all the content within the editing screen here in the middle or the left-hand pane. And then as you make changes, worthy of every song, dude, you can see it updates it over there in the preview window. Now, the cool thing about Proclaim is, let's say you got way too many lyrics on a screen, right? That's four lines. It's really confusing. All you do is put a page break between lyrics and it will make a new slide for those sets of lyrics. Now it's telling me up here one or more lines of this item have been scaled to fit the slide and a line break. Add a line break to refine the layout. So what that's saying is that the font that I'm using is too big and something's not fitting in the box, and what it's done is it's scaled it down. So to give you an idea of what that looks like, we can like say 150 point here and watch what it's gonna do. You can see how it changes the font. The font size is different on the top than it is on the bottom. So it scales things. Let's see if I can find. See, like Live For You is so huge. Jesus, the name above every name. Jesus, the name is very big and above every name is smaller. That's because Proclaim automatically scales things down to fit within the bounding box. No matter how big you try to make the font, it's not ever going to be off the screen. It will scale it and shrink it down to make it fit. The downside of that is that sometimes you have slides that have different size fonts. It's not really that big of a deal. I know for a fact that this one, like that right there, is one of the ones that's been scaled down. That's not a big deal. That's really close, so it's okay. Now, the way that you actually assemble the songs, and this one only has one verse and one chorus in it. Let's flip back over to Glory, for example. So the way you put your songs together is you make sure that you tag a verse in your verse, and you tag your choruses, and you tag your bridges. Now, you notice the chorus is only in there once. We've seen the chorus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times in this song. Well, Proclaim knows that everything from verse 1 to before verse 2, that's verse 1. So you can tell it that you want that to be verse 1, and you can arrange the song however your group, however your worship team, whatever order they sing it in, they arrange the song. So what that looks like is this. So instead of having to sit here and hunt through all of the slides, or if you're, for example, in on-air mode, sitting here and having to click through and find your verse or your chorus, you can do this. You hit C for chorus, and now you're in the chorus. Let's say you want to jump to verse 2. You just hit 2, and you can jump to verse 2. Or if you need to jump back to the chorus, you hit C for chorus. And now we have an instrumental, so we can hit B to go to a blank slide. You can also use your arrows on your keyboard to toggle through the lyrics. So now we're going back into verse 1. So I hit 1 and it jumps to the first one, verse 1. It's not beautiful yet. It's gonna be. Sorry guys, when this song comes on, I can't help but sing it. So like I said, we go back to the chorus. Now this is already in order, so it's going to go to the course of the next arrow. But if you want to go to the bridge and you have blank slides, something to remember here. If you want to go to the bridge, but you have blank slides, double tap the B and it'll take you to the bridge. So that's pretty much how the navigation of song lyrics functions. Let's talk about the media browser here and how you can change the backgrounds on songs. So let's do Build My Life, because I don't want to mess up my glory here. So you, like I said, this is kind of like Pinterest. So you've got different boards here you can pin items to. Then you've got your different, all your different media groups or different series that you're already using in your service. So these are all the different series that I have been pulling from. I'm talking about collections that I've been pulling from for this presentation. And you can narrow it down to what you're looking for. So we're already in a song. So it's already selected. We're looking for songs. And you can say, I want either a still backgrounds or I want a video background. So let's do a video background. And we're doing Build My Life. So let's look for something that's happy. Actually, let's do this. Let's look for water. And you will see here that there are a ton of different backgrounds for water. Now, when you see these that have, let's see, multiple backgrounds like this, that means it's a collection. And there's multiple different types of backgrounds. Let's pick, let's do this one. Apply as background. Now, you're going to notice here in a second when it gets this applied, it has to download the content. We are on the cloud. So once it gets this media applied, inserted, you'll see here, oh, it's in a 16:9 and we're on 4:3. Just go to background and you can go down here and you can say, I want to center that up. So now if we go right click on this element because we want to go on air directly to it, we have very nice mellow background. And if I was setting this up for a Sunday, I would probably more than likely come over here, and that's my changeover from white background to black text, and that'll look a little better because you've got all the white caps there in the. The only reason why I do this is because we have a 4:3 screen and it's not the biggest screen and it's kind of hard to read the lyrics in the back. So putting a solid background behind the lyrics sets them off. And then on our live stream, it also helps differentiate the lyrics from the video as they're laid over the live stream. And that's why I do that the way I do it. Next thing let's talk about adding a video. So let's move back over here to Proclaim test. So we want to add a video. You're going to go up to the top and go add item, add video, and it will bring up a blank area. You come over here and you browse media, select your video that you want to select, whatever it can be. So let's change this video real quick. Let's go to Dan Stevers, see what he's got up. Let's do this one. All right. Apply to video item. So this is our new video we just put in here. It's downloading the content right now. And here's what I don't like about Proclaim. You can't scale media. So you see this is 16:9. We're on a 4:3 screen. So there's going to be bounding bars on top and the bottom. I can't rescale this to fit. I can come here and I can say center it. And I can center it up. But you see it's still not going to be a full screen video. It's going to be black bars. This is actually a really bad
video. I know your story. I've read it cover to cover. And I know the storms that will come.
That works. All right, so this is our new video element here we just added. And it's downloading. So what I'm saying is that if you want to keep it, you can't adjust the format. You can't skew it to fit. You can only blow it up to fit. Or you can adjust it to the top or the bottom of the screen, or you can blow it up to the left-hand side or blow it up the right-hand side. You can't skew the format, the aspect ratio to fit. You just kind of have to live with the way it is. And then you can't lay text over a video element. You'd have to create a song, make this the background for the song, then you could put text on top of it. It gets really kind of just complicated and messy. That way, those are the only things I really don't like about Proclaim. So I think that's pretty much the basics of everything to go over. One more thing I want to talk about, though, real quick, like, is the... Sorry, guys. I'm kind of scatterbrained here near the end. What you can do is if you have an order of service that you kind of stick with, right? So, for example, February 16th. Let's go back to that one that we were just using. This is kind of my order of service we run down, right? We have a welcome, and we have welcome, then we have one call to worship. We have our welcome. We have our three worship songs, offertory song. Then our children's church, the pastor comes up for the sermon. We have an invitation, and then we have our closing prayer. So our format doesn't necessarily change throughout the week. So I never really create a blank slide presentation anymore. I will create a copy of this presentation. This is like my master presentation that I use. And then I will go through here and I will change out songs. So I will replace an item, right? And I know that if we're doing Glory to Glory, for example, or let's see, one of the ones we do a lot, we've been doing is His Mercy is More. So I can say I want to reuse an item and I want to reuse a song that we already did. Here's the cool thing about this is it's all cloud-based and it's all at your fingertips, right? So for example, if we say we're going to end up doing Drenched. That's a good one. Let's do Drenched. Sorry. Drenched. I have two copies of Drenched, and you can see the last time we did them. So I can select this version of Drenched, and it's already formatted with a background and everything. And that's I kind of like that because our congregation gets used to seeing certain songs in certain ways, right? So this is the For His Mercy is More that we use there, okay? And it works very well. And I don't have to sit there and rebuild different backgrounds for a week. Now, there are some times where the pastor will say, hey, I want scenery all week. We're talking about, you know, the burning bush. So,
shut up!
So there are sometimes where the pastor will say, I want a theme for the week, and then I'll have to go through and change those out. But the style of text that I set up for each song, the background that I set up for each song, it kind of stays the same. And that's how I run my presentations, is I don't come in here and create a new blank presentation. I come here and create a new, or I will come in here and do duplicate a recent presentation. So I'll duplicate the 16th. I'll rename it. I haven't even done this week yet, so let's go ahead and do this. I'll rename this Sunday, March 1st, not ready. So I know that anybody who's working with this presentation software, they know that this is Sunday, March 1st, and it is not ready yet. That's really basically the software in a nutshell. If you have questions, you're more than welcome to leave comments. I'm sorry this video was super long, guys. I know that it's boring. You're not watching me. You're watching me on a screen. Hopefully, in the editing process, I cut a lot down and made it a little simpler for you to understand. I appreciate you sticking around with me to this point, though. As always, guys, please subscribe, like the channel, hit the notification bell. We're going to be doing a lot more on Proclaim. When I'm able to get back up to the church after my injury is done, I'm going to show you guys how to do the lyrics over the chroma key to the VMix machine, all that kind of great stuff when we get to that point. So thanks for watching. Y'all have a great service on Sunday. God bless, and we'll see you later.